Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Wa salatu wa salamu ala ashrafil anbiya'i wal mursaleen. Sayyidina Muhammad alayhi afdalus salati wa atammu at-taslim wa ala alihi wa ashabi ajma'in. Amma ba'd. All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We thank Him and we seek His forgiveness, and to Him alone do we repent. We ask that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts our fasting and our prayer and our dua in this holy month. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us by extending our lives to witness yet another Ramadan. It is said that our righteous predecessors would spend 6 months of their lives asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow them to live to the following Ramadan. And then after Ramadan, they would spend the remaining 5 months hoping that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts their fasting, their prayer, and their supplication. Why would they exert such great efforts? قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه الكريم بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم قل يا عبادي الذين أسرفوا على أنفسهم لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله إن الله يغفر الذنوب جميعا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, say, O my servants, who have transgressed against themselves by sinning, despair not of the mercy of Allah. Indeed, Allah forgives all sins. It is He who is forgiving and merciful. Ramadan is a month of forgiveness. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives His slaves and saves them from the hellfire. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then admits them into His mercy, His paradise, and forgives all their sins. Abu Umama radiallahu anhu said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, at every breaking of the fast, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has people whom He redeems from the hellfire. Ramadan is more than just the experience of fasting, or the worship of fasting, or the communal brotherhood bond. Ramadan is a golden opportunity to get our sins forgiven. It offers salvation and access to paradise. Our destination in the hereafter is at stake in this month. And it is quite simple to attain Allah, to attain His forgiveness, and to attain His paradise. It is no surprise, therefore, that when the angel Jibreel said, whoever lives to witness Ramadan and he is not forgiven, may Allah separate him from his Jannah, meaning admits him into hellfire. And the Prophet ﷺ said Ameen to that supplication from Jibreel ﷺ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the all-merciful. He wants to forgive us. He wants to forgive us, and His mercy is beyond our imagination. His forgiveness is so vast that in the hereafter, Yawm al-Qiyamah, on the Day of Judgment, even Shaytan himself will be hoping that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive him. We cannot even begin to conceive the extent of Allah's mercy and His forgiveness. So when a prominent person gives us a gift, he gives us according to his rank, to his status, meaning the gift will be expensive, special, and exclusive. Now imagine this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is gifting us with His mercy and His forgiveness. He is the King of all kings. Should His gift not be worth to us more than anything? And for Allah lies best of examples. He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, knows all of our sins, all of our mistakes, all of our shortcomings, and yet He still showers us with the opportunity of forgiveness. We have to understand, brothers and sisters, that Ramadan is filled with prospects of forgiveness and mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have to make sure to make use of it and to take advantage of this month. How many people were with us last Ramadan and they are not amongst us anymore? How many people do we know that have lost a loved one in the past year? Procrastination is a tool of deception deployed by the shaitan himself. We have to act today and we have to benefit from Ramadan. Various aspects of Ramadan carry the blessings of having our sins forgiven. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us ample of opportunities, many, many opportunities, and He makes it easy for us in this month by removing the distraction of the shaitan. Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu narrates that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, whoever fasts the month of Ramadan with sincere faith and hope and anticipation that Allah forgives his sins, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive all his previous sins. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم من صام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. And we must make sure to make sincere and proper intentions and fast solely for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is the most forgiving. His forgiveness is a cornerstone of Ramadan. Moreover, not only did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us Ramadan, a holy month, but He gave us one of the greatest nights within Ramadan, Laylatul Qadr. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من قام ليلة القدر إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. So what are some things that we should do? What are some actions we must take? What are some ad'iyah that we should be saying in this holy month? Aisha radiallahu anha asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on what she should say to teach her a dua that she can ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam instructs her with the following dua. And it's quite easy. It's a simple dua, and many of us have heard it many times before. The dua, or the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to say this, Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbul afwa fa'fu anni. O Allah, you are the forgiving, and you love to forgive, so forgive me. We can ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala using this dua, this teaching from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So one last time. Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbul afwa fa'fu anni. And inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will respond to our dua and our supplication and will forgive us our sins. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blesses us with so many chances to ensure that we have the most of it, to ensure that our sins are forgiven. He creates paradise for us and He wants to give it to us. However, we must take advantage of this month. We must take advantage of this month and these blessed days and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for His forgiveness. Ramadan is a chance for forgiveness. So we have to ask ourselves, we have to self-reflect and see, do we want to be from those who receive the gifts of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the gift of His mercy and His forgiveness? Or do we want to be from those who Jibreel says, may Allah separate them from His Jannah and admits them to hellfire? So I ask that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts our fasting, accepts our prayer, accepts our dua, and may Allah accept any good deed that we do in this month and after that, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us. Jazakumullah khair ala al-istima'. Thank you so much for listening, and Ramadan Kareem. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.